No. That's it. Thanks for watching. I will see you next time. Now, obviously, to go in a little bit more than this, as you can see from the title, was the Wii U release too late? I came up with this to talk about all of a sudden, basically. But I think it's a good idea. Anyway, I'm not going to be like a lot of people and just bash over the thing because I don't hate it. There's only about two or three consoles I hate because they are legitimately bad. Like, the CDI, stuff like that. But anyway, so if that's what you're thinking I'm doing, if you don't watch my stuff usually, don't worry about it. I'm not doing that. I'm more cynical and objective about this type of thing than pretty much anyone you'll find, like on GameFAQs. But anyway, was it released too late? No, I don't think so. You gotta remember that anymore, they can do well on their own. They don't have to rely on a lot of other things. You might say it's bad. Yeah, it kind of is, but they're going to turn out fine. It's going to take a while. They're going to turn it around like they did with the 3DS. Probably it'll be a little bit different. It'll take a little longer, maybe. I don't know. Handheld's a little bit different than console. Not to mention, it doesn't have the Pokemon games like that does. So that's a big deal on those, as you might know. So it's a little bit different for that. But they're going to still turn it around like they did with the 3DS, and it'll turn out fine. It'll mostly be carried by Nintendo's own first-party stuff and exclusive stuff for it, which is always kind of done. I mean, a lot of people say it. I'll tell you, it's the truth. You get a Nintendo system, console, handheld, whatever one it is, for their stuff. That's the what, why, that's what you do. That is the reason you get one of those. If you want third-party stuff primarily, and you really don't care about any of the stuff, then pretty much anyone and everyone's going to tell you to either get a computer, get an Xbox 360, or get a PlayStation 3. That is of the current ones, you know. Although the Xbox 360 does handle multi-platform games a little bit better than the PlayStation 3, but that's a whole other thing. But it's been this way for a very long time. You get a Nintendo system, whether it might be the handheld or console, for their exclusive stuff. Because if you want to play whatever it might be of their thing, you have to get their system, platform, whatever you want to call it. So even back to the GameCube, if you want to play Smash Bros. Melee, just as an example to get what I'm trying to say out here, you either need a GameCube, a Wii that is capable of playing GameCube games, and that's really your only choices. I mean, yes, there is the Dolphin emulator, but let's say you're not doing emulation. Really, those are the only two ways you can do it. You have to have a Nintendo console. You can't play those on anything else, you know? It's the way it's been, and it's the way it's going to continue to be. Not to mention, also, it's always been that way, ever since the start, you know? Again, taking emulation out of it, if you want to play NES games, unless they put it in some kind of compilation like All-Stars, which they didn't make that many on the Super Nintendo, you had to have it on that and play it. If you want to play any kind of Mario game, you have to have a Nintendo console. Now, is it possible to find something similar to that elsewhere? If you don't want to do that, yeah, it is. I mean, there's games that play like God of War if you don't want God of War or anything like that. There's games that are a lot like Halo, and there's games that are a lot like Mario Brothers. I mean, there's a very famous case, maybe you've heard of it, it's called the Giana Sisters. In fact, it was so close, it was pretty much a ripoff at that point, way back when, and Nintendo actually sued for them to get it off the shelves, and that's what happened. They brought it back many years later, but that's what happens too. A lot of games are a lot similar to each other because in this industry, games are very iterative of each other. They're based on other things that have already come before it. That's why a lot of games, you can't say ripped off Halo for the recharging health or shield thing, because it's basically a mechanic and that's what the whole industry is built on. It's not built on anything else, really. It's built on iterative ideas, so same kind of stuff happens there, which is what I meant by that. But there you go. Overall, that's the reasons why they will be fine. It's the same thing that happened with the Wii. A lot of people thought that thing wasn't going to work out that well either because of the way it was. But, it will. And it did, Yes, no one's debating or denying the fact that majority of people who had it are, quote unquote, my fingers, casuals. I mean, that's kind of what they are. I just don't like using that term. I don't like that labeling stuff. But, that same thing happened there, but that doesn't mean no one who was a genuine Nintendo fan, not a fanboy, as that term is likely used now, an actual legitimate fan, didn't have one, because they did. I had one. more than once, but whatever. I have had one, and I didn't have any of that kind of stuff on it. I only had the actual good stuff on it. It wasn't always Nintendo first party stuff. I had a lot of the light gun shooters on that, you know? And the same thing applies to Wii U. You're gonna get a lot of that kind of stuff on it, even though a lot of third party companies, they either won't deal with them now, or they did a little bit and then they stopped, or whatever it might be. And there's always, obviously, there's a lot of things that will never be on it just because there won't be. Same applies to the other two and even computer. It's nothing new there. But it'll turn out fine. It's just gonna take a while to turn it around like they did with the 3DS. It shouldn't be that way. Again, I don't think anyone's denying that. It shouldn't have turned out that way. But that's the hand they've been dealt now, and that's what they have to work on improving, changing, fixing, so that way everything will turn out all right. I see no reason why this thing could not last as long as the X1 and the PlayStation 4 will or might or whatever you want to call it. I see no reason why it won't. It's just not going to compete with them directly, and it's not going to be exactly with them getting everything that those are. And the PlayStation 4 is not going to get everything the X1 is going to get, and the X1 is not going to get everything that the PlayStation 4 is going to get. Obviously, if you step back and think about this objectively, you'll realize this kind of stuff. Again, it's the same thing I bring up a lot of times when I talk about stuff like this. It's the fact that a lot of people, either they don't know what these are, or they don't understand what the difference is and why one's better than the other. Objectivity and subjectivity, being objective and subjective. It's two different things. You have to. There are things good about everything, and there's things bad about everything, but you have to be able to sort those two apart and actually come up with a correct assessment of something, you know, or situation. It's just the way it is. So that's all I wanted to say. Yeah, that's it. Thanks for listening. I will see you next time. But, you know, as always, say what you think about this. If you think that they can't or won't, and say why, or if you think they do and will, say why you think that way too, or whatever you agree, disagree, whatever you know you want to say. Go ahead. So that's it, and adios.